So let's recap this section really quick. We can be exposed to stressors, and they can be both pleasant and unpleasant, like vacations or marriage or death of a loved one. And both stressors can produce negative emotional responses. And sometimes these negative emotional responses can be difficult to control. And when we encounter a stressful situation, we engage in primary appraisal, which is our first reaction or assessment of a situation. However, upon experiencing the negative emotional response produced by the stressful event, we can also engage in secondary appraisal. Secondary appraisal is using our self-assessment, looking at the resources available to help us cope with the stressful event. By engaging in secondary appraisal, we may be able to reduce the level of negative emotions that we experience. So in the shower handle example I showed you, it nicely demonstrates how I perceive the primary event as very, very stressful. But upon my secondary appraisal, I was able to lower my stress levels because I realized how happy I was that the handle didn't break off while the water was still running. I knew I really lucked out with that one. I also realized the things I needed to do to make the problem go away, such as calling the plumber. And this is a way of coping with the situation. So this again demonstrates that it's a person's perceived ability to deal with a stressful event or stressor that results in a negative emotional response to stress. If, however, I was a handy plumber myself and the shower came off, I wouldn't perceive the event as stressful at all. I would just fix it myself because I would have the skills I needed to solve the problem. Now, I might still be a little stressed about the things I need to do to get the handle fixed, but not as much as I could be, because I figured out how I want to solve the problem.